I would like to invite you to unique territories with amazing itineraries in contact with the traditions of local communities for unforgettable experiences. Let's start this journey in discovering together the regions of Romagna and Marche. We will visit sacred places, archaeological sites, and also ancient villages. We will live emotional experiences through landscapes that are designed with poetry by people and nature. So, a territory where every place is an excellence, where every village is the most beautiful village. So, let's go! Sant'Arcangelo is one of the most picturesque villages in the heart of Romagna, not far from the sea and from Rimini. Here you can really enjoy the typical Italian lifestyle and you can taste the typical food specialties, homemade pasta, piadina and the Sangiovese wine.
Hi, I'm Erika. Sant'Arcangelo di Romagna is rich in history and has a mysterious side. In fact, within the hill, there is a network of more than 150 galleries carved into the sandstone. Most of these date back to the Middle Ages, but some, including this one, has even older origins and have been created for religious reasons. Over the centuries, the caves have been used also as wine cellars, food storage, and shelters during the Second World War. Sant'Arcangelo is the city of artists. In recent times, it has become known for its murals created by Italian artists like Erika Il Cane and Aaron. In Sant'Arcangelo you can also find an artistic village founded by the Mutoid Waste Company, a group of artists which came to Sant'Arcangelo in the 90s upon invitation to the International Theatre Festival, which is the oldest theatre festival in Italy. One of them can tell you more about it.
Hi there, I'm Nikki and I'm part of a group of artists called the Mutoid Waste Company. We have a base in Sant'Arcangelo di Romagna. And this is our home, this is where we live. Our space is called Mutonia. We use recuperated materials, this is our philosophy. We create sculptures, we create installations for bars and clubs and shows, fire shows, moving creatures. We've created over 30 years a space that's a little out of the ordinary, I think you might find if you manage to get here. The important part of our work is the fact that we give life to all waste material that is thrown away, whether it's from industry, whether it's from whatever business, from whatever farmhouse, we recycle, and we give a new energy and a new life to pieces of waste.
From street art and recycling artists and performers to the most ancient form of art. In the region of Marche, we go through diverse ages, attraction of great touristic and cultural value.
Hi, I'm Martina. I would like to introduce you for Sombrone, a city rich of history through the centuries. Here, Casa Museo Quadrerio Cesarini, you can visit a house and also a museum donated to our community by the notary Giuseppe Cesarini. We are in the 20th century, and this house museum will carry you directly into the atmosphere of a rich bourgeois family of the 40s. You can admire one of the few examples of a perfectly preserved environment, the red living room, the elegant and refined pink living room, the curtains, the awesome porcelain, and some magnificent golden mirrors. Another even deeper dive is into the life of ancient Rome, the so-called archaeological park Forum Semproni. Founded in the 2nd century before Christ, Fossombrone was an important Roman center during the so-called Imperial Splendor. In this great archaeological site, you can admire the ruins of Roman city of Forum Semproni. There are the remains of numerous private and public buildings. Then there is the ruin of a domus with valuable floor mosaics exhibited at the Archaeological Museum. Last but not least, Fossombrone has also a magical place, actually the symbol of the city, the Concordia Bridge. Known as the Eye, its unique arch reflects on the river, forming almost a perfect circle. A poetic and exciting image of Fossombrone.
You can live the same emotional atmosphere with an adventure in the nature. The canyon called Marmitte dei Giganti, literally meaning giant spots, is one of the most fascinating places in the Marche, which can be visited by kayak and along the many trails for trekking and hiking enthusiasts.
Ciao a tutti, sono Natalia e oggi vi presento questo canyon, che è una spaccatura all'interno della roccia che si è creato 200 milioni di anni fa e ha delle pareti maestose che arrivano fino a 30 metri di altezza dal livello dell'acqua. Le marmitte dei giganti sono molto importanti perché le ha scolpite attraverso le rocce il fiume Metauro e arrivano a un diametro di 3-4 metri. La definizione marmitta sta per pentola, perché noi abbiamo 5 cavità, le più importanti, che si sono scolpite con l'aiuto del movimento dell'acqua e i sassi che il fiume ha trascinato al suo interno. Infatti la leggenda dice che i giganti venivano qua a cuocere in queste pentole.
In the lovely places of Terra Nostra, you can experience an ecotourism with zero environmental impact. Some of these villages have a vocation for hospitality and sustainable tourism, like Brisighella in Romagna.
Hello, I am Silvia. Brisighella is considered one of the most beautiful medieval villages in Italy, dating back to the 13th century. It is set around three pinnacles that host the Rocca Manfrediana, the clock tower called Torre dell'Orologio, and the Monticino Sanctuary. Among the ancient city walls, you can stroll here around the Via del Borgo, a unique elevated porticoed street also called the Donkey Path. It was here that caravans pulled by donkeys transported the material for the nearby gypsum quarries of the Vena del Gesso Romagnola Regional Park. The creation of the park means we can protect and promote the area, which is a rare example of a hill range made exclusively of selenite gypsum crystals, a UNESCO Natural Heritage Site. In this unique territory are located several notable buildings, including the Romanesque Church of San Giovanni in Ottavo, also called Pieve del To, built in the 8th century, one of the oldest in Emilia-Romagna. The town received important certifications such as International Slow City and City of Oil. Here we can taste Brisighello, our famous DOP extravergine olive oil, and the Sangiovese and Albana di Romagna wines. A delicious experience.
The soil in these areas is generous and diverse. In Marche, a particular type of white clay started to typical production that narrate about the deep connection between territory and culture.
Hello, I'm Luca. Frate Rosa is known for the production of terracotta and for the typical cultivation of broad beans. The ancient nucleus of the town with the typical spiral plan is guarded with these picturesque pink brick houses within the medieval walls. Frate Rosa is famous throughout the world for the artisanal production of terracotta. The so-called Cocci di Frate Rosa are still produced today by Frate Potters with a lot of passion, with workshop to transmit a centuries-old tradition opened to tourists and locals. The terracottas are unique in their colors and shapes, and the typical colors are honey and black. Even the name is linked to this land. Until the 19th century, it was only called Frate. Later, Rosa was added, that it seems to derive from the typical terracotta color of the houses. They shine pink at the sunset. In this area, the excellence is the fava of Frate Rosa, which has become a slow food presidium for biodiversity heritage to protect our future and our planet. For many years, the broad bean represented the basic food for the local population. Fresh or dried, it was an ingredient in many home recipes and transformed into flour. In fact, the typical dish here is tacconi, and made pasta mixing wheat flour and beans flour. Come to discover the jewel of our land.
Ciao, sono Sylvie. Nello stesso territorio, nelle dolci colline delle Marche, si erge Mondavio. Mondavio dichiarato uno tra i borghi più belli d'Italia, da sempre contraddistinto dalla sua celebre e maestosa rocca, realizzata dall'architetto Francesco Di Giorgio Martini nel 1482 al 1492, considerata la massima espressione d'arte fortificatoria del Rinascimento italiano proprio per la sua forma così particolare, così perfetta. Una base ottagonale, pareti trapezoidali, tutte inclinate e poste ad abitamento tra loro, con degli angoli molto vivi, molto sfuggenti, proprio per sdeviare e contrastare la polvere da sparo e le armi da fuoco. Dall'alto della rocca si vede un torrione a forma di balestra, firma dell'architetto Francesco Di Giorgio Martini. Mondavio è sede di rievocazione storica da 60 anni, col suo celebre evento Caccia al Cinghiale. Dal 1959 si è costituito il gruppo storico Arcieri Balestrieri Corte Roveresca di Mondavio, composto da ancelle, corte, armati, musici, si tramandano abilità e si tengono in vita tradizioni di generazione in generazione. Le ragazze iniziano a ballare presto le danze rinascimentali, come i stessi ragazzi iniziano a suonare tamburo e chiarina, a maneggiare arco e balestra. La Rocca prende vita con spettacoli teatrali, visite con personaggi che accompagnano i visitatori all'interno delle sale, immergendoli in un'atmosfera completamente rinascimentale. A pochi passi dalla Rocca Roveresca troviamo il Teatro Apollo, uno dei più piccoli teatri delle Marche, realizzato alla metà del 1600 su un'antica costruzione religiosa che sorgeva nella metà del 400. Nella metà del 700 si è deciso di ampliarlo e decorarlo in stile Liberty.
Will unveil another village situated on the Apennines Mountains in Romagna.
Hi, I'm Roberta. Sarsina is one of the richest towns for history, culture and religiosity in Romagna. But above all, Sarsina is a destination for religious tourism thanks to the legend of the collar of Saint Vicinio, used by the first bishop of Sarsina between the 3rd and the 4th century to bless the faithful and to counteract demonic possessions and diseases. According to tradition, the saint used to pray with a chain around his neck to which a heavy boulder was tied and invoke God's help against the evil one. Today, the Church of Saint Vicinio is a destination for numerous faithful who come here for a blessing wearing the chain. During the Roman Empire, this small village became an important and prestigious city, and today is famous for being the birthplace of a great Roman playwright, Plautus. In fact, the Plautus Festival is organized every summer in his honor. Moreover, in the National Archaeological Museum of Sarsina, one of the most important of Northern Italy, you will find many valuable works, such as the extraordinary Mausoleo of Rufus, more than 13 meters high. You can also admire a large mosaic from Adomus, depicted the triumph of Dionysus, the god of wine. It was the floor of the dining room where the ancient Romans used to eat while lying on a particular sofa called triclinium. Sarsina is waiting for you.
One of the jewels of Sarsina is the ancient village of Calbano, where a niche craftsman lives.
Ciao, sono Elvis, io mi occupo della costruzione di chitarre classiche di scuola italiana che sono ormai scomparse, diciamo, dai primi decenni del 1900. E questo per tentare di riportare in vita tutte quelle caratteristiche costruttive, così come i materiali degli strumenti del nostro paese in quel periodo storico che va dalla seconda metà del 1700 sino alla prima metà del 1800. Questa mia grande passione mi porta a tentare di tramandare tutte queste pratiche antiche, soprattutto chitarre, per non perdere oltre 400 anni di scuola italiana, una grande ricchezza del nostro paese.
Precious melody in the lovely places, as an immersive experience engraved in your heart forever.